Welcome back, everyone. This is the Walkthrough of the Lost Crown, Part 39, and I'm Elfin Angel. We've discovered Ganwold's first... what's left of his old kingdom, supposedly. And we've been collecting some mysterious discs, like this one. This would be the second so far. Discovered what looks to be an ancient dining hall.
The tapestry features three crowns. A link. A definite link to the legend. I must be getting close.
Now this mysterious little object looks like a kiln. But as you can hear, it makes strange noises. You're supposed to match the sounds with the recording that we got, but I'll give you the solution anyway. We are now faced with yet another wraith. So these stones apparently show us scenes from our arrival in our time in Saxton. You're supposed to begin here, from your arrival at Sedgemarsh, and then proceed to sort of narrate the story as you've experienced it. My bad. terribly sorry about that. My computer derped a bit. Anyway, let's examine what we uncovered from the wraith. Ah! It appears that this is where the stone discs that we've been finding fit, but we need to find one more before we can solve this. So let's head back and see if we've missed anything.
Nothing ventured.
Here we have a little puzzle to solve. If you remember correctly, these are the symbols of the seasons. This is winter. This is spring, summer, and autumn. So we basically have to rotate these two little discs in order to match the animals and the elements with each season. It's a bit tricky if you don't know what you're doing, and it can be confusing. But you basically want the serpent or dragon under winter. And the last piece of the disc is ours. Now these will go only in certain ways, so you don't need to worry so much about it. It's a bit of a hassle to get this going, so I can't guarantee that the solution I'm going to give you is the fastest or the best. Maybe there's a faster way, I don't know. Sorry, that was my phone.
Thank you.
ventured.
As I've said before, Nigel has balls. I don't know if anybody else would do that without safety equipment or something. Someone isn't happy with what we've done. We now have the crown in our possession, and naturally Nigel, and we, is probably wanting to boogie all the way back to Saxton and get out of the woods. It's normal that Nigel's sounding a bit paranoid considering everything he's seen so far. I don't think anybody can blame him. Well, except for fucking up the natural order of things, apparently. Since, as you can see, something isn't happy with what we've done.
A shadowy force is blocking my way.
We'll, continue our escape from this thing in the next video. Stay safe, and I'll see you all later.